No one is safe until everyone is safe. This has been the most significant lesson for us through the last 15 months of this pandemic. Every time we feel that the worst is behind us, a new hotspot, a new variant, something comes up and we feel that we are back to where we were. Apart from the health challenges, this crisis has exposed a lot of fault lines in our socioeconomic fabric, growing income inequality, the deterioration of the environment. These are topics that have been discussed now for a long time, and yet the needle doesn't move. In fact, during this crisis, the income inequality has widened. 25 people today in the world have more than $50 billion of wealth. And 500 individuals added $2 trillion of wealth through the last 1 year, a 31% increase. The environment took a breather, but poverty alleviation, income inequality, not so much. In fact, a recent Washington Post article talks about the various sections of society that have not yet fully recovered, even though the headlines look good in terms of job recoveries. Mothers of school-going children, people of color, people who don't have a college degree, all of these people have not yet recovered the jobs that they were there before the pandemic. In fact, just to give you one statistic, women of color have probably been the most impacted. Only 34% of those jobs have returned till date, as per that report. Now, manufacturing is probably the most visible and tangible value creation engine that one sees in the economy. Manufacturing has been evolving. It's been moving towards what is scholars call flexible specialization. Manufacturing, the next generation of manufacturing is called Industry 4.0. Industry 4.0 means automation, more of automation, more of robots, more of artificial intelligence. All that means is that manufacturing is set to become even more exclusive and even more specialized. Technology today enables you to order a product by swiping your mobile phone, and this product could be manufactured thousands of miles away, will show up at your doorstep in less than 2 days sometimes, or maybe a couple of hours. In fact, people who are testing drones to drop them on your doorstep. Now, this is a well-orchestrated, highly optimized supply chain that has been around for some time now. And yet, this was the supply chain which broke down during the crisis. This was the first visible sign of the fragility of this manufacturing ecosystem that exists today. If you remember, among the first things that were impacted during the crisis last year was the availability of masks, of shields. People were desperate, especially in our frontline healthcare workers. They did not have enough masks to protect themselves. And that happened because of a disruption in the supply chain. I lead a Boston-based 3D printing company called Rise, which is focused on environmentally safe full color 3D printing. And we joined our industry brethren in an initiative to print, to produce these PPEs. Thousands of PPEs were produced. They were rushed on a daily basis. They were produced at, and this was a time when there was a lockdown, they were produced in homes, in garages, in basements, in kitchens by individuals, by school children, and they were rushed to people who really needed them, the ever grateful healthcare workers. In fact, I remember driving 100 miles to deliver these shields, these face shields, to a hospital in New Hampshire, and there was the head of the ICU standing outside to pick them up. What was done was manufacturing, which was, and supply chains, which were this humongous enterprise, suddenly got compressed into a micro effort. And what we discovered through this was the power of self-sufficiency. 3D printing is around now and is impacting our lives quite a bit. For those people who go to a dentist, for example, almost everything that you see around in terms of aligners, braces, crowns, these are all 3D printed now. There are lots of parts that go into an aircraft that are 3D printed. However, here we had the makings of something different, which is, could consumers become creators? And we said, maybe there is an idea here to drive an inclusive approach towards manufacturing. What if we could train people with low skills in this technology? What if they could produce parts? Parts that could be medical models, they could be industrial parts, they could be toys, any of these parts which could generate income. What would be required here? What kind of skills would be required? What kind of scaffolding would be required to make these people productive, and especially productive enough to create a living wage? So that's the idea with which we went to create a series of pilots. We are supported here by a number of organizations who are from diverse backgrounds, but have a common thread in terms of commitment to social equity. We are supported also by the World Economic Forum, which is running a massive program on shaping the future of advanced manufacturing and creating new business models. What we are doing here is creating an ecosystem which has what we call explorers. These explorers are individuals who are willing to learn, willing to experience this technology, but have no background in 3D printing. In most cases, they have low skills. They are finding it difficult to find a job. We have now signed up people who have autism, people who have come back from a war, people who have been out of a job for a while. They are being supported by what we have called navigators. Navigators are mentors, coaches, who are skilled in the technology, who have a knowledge of this technology and are willing to help. Also in this ecosystem are what we call anchors. Anchors are large companies who are willing to lean in, who are willing to identify use cases and applications that could potentially generate income in the future. And we have propellers who are technologists just like us and who are willing to provide the technology backbone to enable this new ecosystem. And what we want to do through this process is figure out whether we can make manufacturing more inclusive, whether we can make people create a living wage out of this technology. And most importantly, in this small project is embedded the big idea of creating a self-sufficient production ecosystem. When I started my career, computer literacy was the best buzzword. If you knew spreadsheets, if you had taken the time to learn even basic tools like word processing, you looked smarter and you looked much more employable. 3D printing literacy probably is heading in that same direction now. Don't be surprised if you would be printing parts in the near future. Just the way you're printing documents and pictures, you may be printing parts at home and without much of knowledge and expertise. So I want you to think about this. Would you like to be an explorer on a journey like this? Or if you already know 3D printing, would you like to be a navigator to help someone be an explorer? And if you happen to be working in a company which already produces parts, manufactures, and maybe does it with 3D printing or even without, would you like to anchor a community in your area? And if you happen to be a propeller, would you be willing to help someone cross this chasm and bring them to the safety of being a productive member of society? Because only when everyone is safe are we individually safe. Thank you.